you so much. Very good morning to all of you. We have a very experienced panel here, and I'm sure that we are going to learn a lot about cloud, which is one of the latest buzz in the SME ecosystem. So we can start with Shreesh.
Cloud is not something which it is made out to be. It is not something great or something which is entirely different. It makes life of us easy, the IT part of the organization easier. But for the users, for the management, the system on cloud and system on premises does not make much of a difference. Except for the CFO, of course, because there is a lot of savings. They will be happy that OPEX has been converted in, CAPEX has been converted into OPEX. The three basic fears everybody has is that one is loss of control, second is security, third is the connectivity. We had some bank CIOs talking to with each other, and they were saying that, okay, it is not safety in cloud. One of the persons asked, as a banker, do you advise me to keep all my valuables, money, gold and all, in your bank locker or in my home locker, which is in my home? Bank people said, obviously you should keep in banks. Why? Because there are better securities, better processes, there are people dedicated to guard your valuables. In your home, you don't have. And this exactly reflects what cloud and non-cloud application is. Security is much better if you go onto cloud, because those are professionals who are handling. And if you have an access to outside world, a system on cloud will be more secure than the system on your premises. Then second part is loss of ownership. There have been a lot of discussions going on whether my data is staying within my premises, more safe, under my control, or something outside. Actually, if you are opening out to the external entities, your in-house data center or in-house data source is as vulnerable as any outside data center, data source. So control is just what you think, okay, I have kept a room locked with a key, but I have provided the network connectivity onto the internet for my employees, and somebody can hack as easily as any other system and get your data. Third is connectivity. This is one of the biggest issues I've heard from most of the people. Everybody says that I've got all the applications on cloud, and if the last mile connectivity breaks, because most of the small industries don't or cannot afford to have multiple redundant lease lines and app connections. So they say that if the connection breaks, I'm not working. But that today, in today's world, with lot of options for connectivity over the internet, over the VPNs, over the lease lines, definitely people will be safe. Because nobody talks about connectivity when you're talking on your apps on your mobile. We take it for granted that there will be connectivity. Same connectivity can work if properly configured for the applications in the cloud.
So Shreesh, in fact, you've given a very different perspective of security and ownership, because these are the two major factors why a SME doesn't want to shift to cloud. But you've given a very different perspective. So I think, that is something to be considered. It's not about actually controlling something and being secure in-house. I mean, you have to look at experts, yes, but then larger organizations hosting the cloud, they are more trustworthy. So that is something which a comparison needs to be done. Sanjeev, can we have something?
So, with regard to cloud, the right strategy plays a very, very important role. Because what happens actually in SMEs, people spend money, either some small setup, PCs, some application, and because they have a priority, they meet some demand, quality commitments, supply delivery commitments, all that, because they are supplying to OEMs. And then what happens, you know, after investing money there, then the question comes, you know, then what is that, you know, cloud which is coming, you know? So we are anyhow managing our demand, delivery, supply, everything. And then we have some setup, you know, some setup. Where to begin? What to begin? What to choose first? So strategy, like, you know, evaluating your business, evaluating your process, and then creating right cloud strategy is very, very important. So for example, one case I would like to, one small case, you know, where the company was trying to move to ERP. And the company was having a homegrown ERP, and it was very, very good, running quite well for production, supply chain, quality, warranty system, including finance and account. You know, but you know, the company was having a desire, vision to grow, go beyond boundaries. And then the company decided, so let us break this barrier and move to cloud. And the moment, you know, they implemented cloud-based, it was initial hiccup, you know, because you are losing control. When you have a habit of seeing, you know, the IT system, network, server, etc., all of a sudden nothing is there, you know. It is on cloud, and then you have anytime, anywhere concept coming in. Like your people on move can interact with application, update data and all. So there, you know, the company started, you know, that let us move, you know, HR application first. Let us move, you know, on the billing application first. Let us move that CRM first, you know, it's like that. And that's how they created strategy, and they keep evaluating, you know, each and every application, each and every module, and then finally move to cloud. Now, when it comes to security, you know, as you see, Shreesh gave example of bank, whether, you know, it's right to keep, you know, data within on-premise or move to cloud. The here issue is, you know, that the very recently, government has taken decision demonetization, you know. Like, you know, you keep money in bank, you know, keeping cash in is very dangerous. So there's another tendency, you know, that keep data there, then, you know, it will not be exposed, and then while submitting the financial, we have all the controls and all. So that scares a lot, you know. But I'm telling you, nowadays, cloud is fully secured, and all the security measures are in place, and people are moving. Cloud.
The execution part is very, very important.
Strategy and execution both.
Yes. Yeah. So maybe the training from the service provider will help in streamlining the entire process. So which cloud-based solution is your organization?
No, it depends. You know, I'll tell you, cloud has, because, you know, again, the cloud strategy, when I said, you know, signing agreement is just one part. You know, what kind of application you want to run on cloud. Suppose, you know, you have all of a sudden load increasing in say, we call, you know, sales peaking at the month end. Like in the third week or fourth week, you know, all of a sudden, sales go up. We generally see that in FMCG. Now, when we say sales go up, it doesn't mean, you know, that customers start buying more at that time. It's like, you know, there is a sales target, quantity target. We start pushing more to retailers or distributors. That's how it is. So there, you know, if you want to move such application on cloud, then you need cloud burst kind of, you know. So there, you know, you need AWS or Microsoft kind of, you know. So otherwise, you have so many cloud players for regular application. Yeah.
Great. Prasad, if you can share.
The readiness of SMEs and the investment appetite is actually preventing them from using any cloud-based solution which is on a scale or which is in terms of price. So this kind of solutions are coming in the market where somebody is building the solution, you're using it only for paper use. I'm not saying full-fledged ERP. The solution which we built was an enterprise class application, which is handling only purchase orders and GRRs and other manufacturing related or transaction related detail. So that was something which we did almost like 5 years ago, and it has been pretty successful. We sold out the solution to somebody else. Which is now running also for Maruti and their suppliers, which are coming from SME area.